Celebrity bodyguards deal with a lot. Their job is to protect their boss from everything and everyone. But because they work so closely with their bosses, they often end up being their closest confidant. And that means they see a lot of crazy shit. I'm about to count down the top 10 celebrities exposed by their former bodyguards here for you on IO. Welcome back to Inform Overload. We do the news, we spill the tea, and oh my god, do I have some tea to spill today. By the way, I'm Charlotte. I can tell we're gonna be friends. I can tell you like weird people. Cause you would have clicked off this video if you didn't. Subscribe so we get to hang out every day and follow the IO team on social media so we can connect outside of YouTube. So, little disclaimer, like the rest of my videos on former employees of celebrities, you should keep in mind that the bodyguards on this list might have had incentive to rat out their bosses to the public and the media. Maybe they had a book deal in the works, maybe they just wanted to be famous themselves, so take all of these confessions with a grain of salt. In at number 10, we have Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie. Former bodyguard of Brad and Angelina, Mark Billingham, said in an interview with a UK tabloid, I quote, "Once it was Angie's birthday and they were all sitting in an Audi Q7. He hadn't been working with them long and suddenly Brad has the doors locked and farted so they couldn't get out." That's weird. At least make sure the doors are unlocked before you rip one. Damn. Like, was that like on purpose? I'm confused. I have questions. I have a lot of questions about this part. Mark went on to say that Brad and Angelina were pretty naive when it came to their personal security. He said, "What surprised me was their low level of common sense. I found it crazy when they would ask me questions like, how do I go down to that bar? And what do I need to get there?" Does being a celebrity just mean they like need advice on how to wipe their ass? "Well, Brad and Angelina, you walk. You do this thing, you lift up your feet, and you walk. Have you ever heard of it?" Probably not. Probably get driven around in an Audi Q7 everywhere you go. Mark eventually quit after 18 months because the job was too high pressure. In at number 9, we have Justin Bieber. Justin Bieber's former bodyguard, Mosh Benabou, I hope I'm saying that correctly, filed a complaint against him in LA after Bieber physically assaulted him. He claimed that Justin went on a tirade against him that was triggered by what Justin perceived as an attempt to keep one member of Bieber's entourage physically away from Justin Bieber. Bieber then punched Benabou in the chest and upper body. But rather than fight back, he did nothing. Justin's former bodyguard also sued Justin for unpaid overtime, vacation wages, expenses, and failure to pay wages due immediately on termination. At number 8 on our list, we got Mr. Eminem. Byron Williams wrote a memoir in 2000 called Shady Business: Life as Eminem's Bodyguard in an Industry of Paper Gangsters. Williams said that the book documented various moments about his time working for Eminem, including a scary encounter with Suge Knight, who allegedly sent henchmen to threaten Eminem. He said in a 2016 interview with Vibe, "When I wrote the book, it was never my intention to attack Eminem, but we had a falling out financially and I decided to write the book to recoup some of the money that I lost." AV Club said about the book that it was a pathetic portrayal of Eminem as an irresponsible, deeply unhappy man-child who relies on his bodyguard slash self-styled mentor slash babysitter slash conscience slash better half slash life coach for everything. What a review. The two are still reportedly not on good terms. During their last interaction, they both had their hands on their weapons. At number 7, we have Britney Spears. I feel like she's on every single celebrity expos list that I've ever done. I swear, it's not on purpose, there's only so many celebrity bodyguard stories, so. Fernando Flores was Britney Spears' former bodyguard, and back in 2010, he filed a lawsuit against her, where he claimed that she sexually harassed him and made unwanted advances. Like, I get that it's nice to feel protected and stuff, but it's still harassment in the workplace to make passes at your bodyguard. Flores said that Britney exposed herself quite a few times. Now, Britney alleged that she never did any of this, and her former bodyguard was only trying to take advantage of her to make a name for himself, or so she says. They settled out of court 2 years later for an undisclosed amount. At number 6, we have Kanye West. Steve Stanulis is an ex-NYPD officer who's protected celebrities like Leonardo DiCaprio, and he was also the bodyguard of Kanye West and Kim Kardashian. But he was fired back in 2016 because Kanye accused him of making a move on Kim. Stanulis told the Daily Mail that he never made a move on Kim, and Kanye needs to, quote, "chill the f*** out." I mean, that's fair. He does need to chill the f*** out. Stanulis didn't really have that many good things to say about Kanye, who was allegedly particularly difficult to work for. He described the entire experience as being forgettable, traumatic, not worth it, and disappointed. Stanulis said Kanye would have temper tantrums all the time, and he would seldom offer his staff a glass of water. Stanulis also said that Kanye wouldn't let him wear anything other than black because, quote, "patterns distract him." In at number 5, Elton John. Yet another bodyguard on this list who claims the star they protected sexually harassed them. Back in 2016, Jeffrey Wenninger sued Elton John for sexually harassing him while he worked for him. According to the lawsuit, between 2002 and 2014, Elton John, quote, inappropriately touched Jeffrey on multiple occasions and made sexually suggestive comments. Sexually suggestive comments like, get your todger out and say hello to Uncle Elton. He said it exactly like that, okay? My British accent is impeccable. Wenninger alleges that the incidents got more frequent and more intense after 2010. Elton, of course, denied all of this and the case ended up being dismissed. Wenninger received no financial compensation or settlement. In at number 4, we have Morrissey. Frontman of the Smiths, Morrissey was sued by his former bodyguard Bradley Stain, who claimed that Morrissey and his manager asked him to harm a man who ran a Morrissey fan website, morrissey-solo.com. The guy that ran the website was a guy named David Singh, and Morrissey gave Stain his address and wanted him to hurt him. When Stain refused, he was fired. Stain sought over £155,000 in compensation, damages, and legal costs. Morrissey denied all of this and called it a lie. He said in a statement, "The very idea that I would ask a complete stranger to physically attack David Singh surely cannot register with any sane person as being likely." He went on, "As mildly irritating as David Singh may be, he is not someone who troubles me enough to even bother with." In at number 3, we've got David Bowie. I love me some David Bowie, but being a rock star means you probably got a few secrets when it comes to romantic relationships. Or encounters. According to former Bowie bodyguard Stuart George, who worked for him for almost 14 years, he once had to guard the door while David Bowie had a menage a trois with Mick Jagger from the Rolling Stones and a famous British female singer that he did not disclose. This was back in the 1970s, so like, people were pretty like free-spirited and like bisexual. Doesn't really surprise me a lot. They wanted to experiment, guys. The threesome supposedly happened in a walk-in closet filled with Bowie's costumes, and that's when Bowie told his bodyguard to wait outside and make sure they weren't interrupted. I wonder if they like wore all the costumes. I have such a funny image in my head. In the number 2, we got Elvis. Three of Elvis's former bodyguards worked together to write a book about the King of Rock called Elvis: What Happened. Sonny West, David Helber, and Red West claim various things in the book. Elvis, quote, charmed a beautiful young fan into joining him on a drug binge for two that almost killed her. He also allegedly took a group of friends on a 3 a.m. visit to a mortuary to look at corpses and talk about embalming. Cause that's not weird. Elvis also admitted to one of these former bodyguards that he sent out a hit on a man that he felt stole his wife. The book, Elvis: What Happened, ended up being published 4 days before Elvis died in 1977. So that's awkward. And at number 1 on our list, Michael Jackson. Now, this one was crazy. Maybe you remember it. Back in 2010, Michael Jackson's former bodyguard, Matt Fids, claimed that he was the real father of Michael Jackson's son, Blanket. Fids said he donated sperm to Michael back in 2001 because Michael wanted to have an athletic child. Matt was a martial arts expert. He said to the Daily Mail, "Jackson said he wanted a fit, athletic son. He offered me £500,000, but I said no. I was already a multimillionaire and I didn't need the money or want to take his." In 2009, a mutual friend saw a picture of Blanket in a magazine and rang me straight away, and he said, "What have you done? You've donated sperm to Michael." He saw the likeness straight away. So just so you know, to date, there's been no test to prove that Fids is Blanket's biological father. But that wasn't all Matt Fids had to say about Michael Jackson. He made further claims in 2012 that Jackson had a secret affair with Whitney Houston that Jackson never got over. He also said that Michael Jackson was unable to have children because of his excessive drug use. He was also anorexic, and Jackson was convinced he would be assassinated. Well guys, there you have it. Do you believe any of these confessions? Let me know in the comments, and while you do that, I'm gonna wrap this one up with some comment features. Zamorak said, "I found IO when y'all had 2K subs. Seeing how much y'all grown makes me proud."
I like it when people are proud of me. Feels good.
Char Bear said, "Happiness is when your favorite IO host is Charlotte and your name happens to be Charlotte too."
Yay!
I don't know what to say to that. I have a really good friend named Charlotte as well. Steven Universe said, "Finally, a Charlotte episode. Guys, I'm literally in almost every other video on this channel. It's not like I go away for days at a time. I make sure I'm in a video every single day on this channel, so none of that. Don't give me that." That's it for me. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, you should leave a like,
please.
Subscribe,
please.
And I'll see you in a future IO video.
Please.
I forgot to put the number. Moshe Benabou. Moshe Benabou. Let's go with that. Moshe Benabou.
Moshe.
Moshe? Moshe? I had a blanket. Did you have blankets or teddy bears? Yeah, I had a blanket.
Yeah.